17 says, so Saul said to his servant, provide for me a man who can play well and bring him to me. Saul said, provide for me a man and he'll bring him to me. He'll play and it's going to help me in this situation. You know what is good? And I'm moving. You know what's good? That disobedience is very expensive. Saul provides. Saul has to go out and get something else because he won't do what God has already told him. Disobedience is very, very expensive. He had to go get something. Let me get out of here, y'all. Oh my God. Look at here. So this brother dealing with some sinister suffering. And then see the next thing I see, we see some skills develop in stealth. Lord have mercy. We see some skills develop in stealth. Yes, we do. Yes, we do. Sinister suffering because of his disobedience. But then we see some skills develop in stealth. See, when you're after God's own heart, when you're a man or woman after God's own heart, there's some skills that you'll be developing when nobody sees you. Here it is. Look at verse 18. It says, one of the young men answered, behold, I have seen a son of Jesse, the Bethlehemite. It says, who is skillful in playing, a man of valor, a man of war, prudent in speech, and a man of good presence. Look at this. It says, and the Lord is with him. Here, Day-Day, I call David Day-Day, y'all. Here, Day-Day is minding his own business, taking care of his father's sheep. And here, in the presence of royalty, somebody has his name in their mouth because of what he developed when nobody was watching. Y'all missed it. See here, God can have your name in rooms your feet have never been in. God can have your name in rooms that you never walked in. God can have your name at tables you never sat at. God can have you in negotiations and you never even knew what was going on. Here they said, I saw Day-Day, but Day-Day is his one. This brother, he's a son of Jesse. He's skillful in playing. He's a man of valor, man of war. Oh, he's a capable man, is what they're telling the king. He's capable and he's mighty. This brother is very clever. This brother got a wit about him. They're talking about David and all of these things that they named about David. David developed in the dark. Oh, what am I trying to tell you, my friend? I'm trying to tell you that God is trying and desiring to do some things in our life. And the only way he's able to do these things in our life. See, we wait for the platform in order for God to be able to start doing and working in our life. No, my friend. You won't get to the platform, whatever your platform may be, until you've been developed in the dark. Oh, my friend, and if you get to the platform before you've been developed in the dark, timber, come on here, my friend. The bigger they are, the bigger they are, the harder they fall. And what God said, let me get all of that developing out in a low season, in a meager season, when nobody knows you, when nobody sees you, and I'll let you go through all that development before I let you stand on the platform, before I push you out there. And God is saying there's some things that need to be developed. On behalf of everyone here at Truth and Love Ministries, we want to thank you for being a part of our online worship experience. Thank you for your participation through your likes, your shares, and your comments. But we also want you to participate when it comes down to helping us continue to push this gospel message forward. You can do so by downloading our app, and you can give there in a safe and secure way. You can go to our website at truthandlove.tv, and you can give. Or you can text the word TILJAX to the number 77977. Thank you so much for your generosity. Thanks for watching. Be blessed. See you next time.